Hello friends, I'm Naishik from blogdude.com and welcome to another amazing video. In this video, I'll teach you how to make a professional and beautiful hotel booking website with WordPress. This website will have all the features required by a professional hotel booking website. Now let me show you the demo of the website that we are going to create in this video. So this is the website that we'll be creating in this video, the website which you see on your screen. Now this is the first section, the top section, the header section. As you can see, the navigation bar is transparent. It does not have any background color as such. And this is really looking beautiful. Now we have a title and subtitle over here. After that, we have another section. This is the reservation bar section. Here the person can put in the check-in date, select how many nights you want to stay for, or put in the checkout date over here and select the number of adults and children who want to stay. Then they can check the availability. We'll see this process later on. First, let's see the design of the website. After that, we'll go into how the process works, how the payment works and so on. Okay. After that, we have another section. Here we have all our rooms showing over here, all your hotels, your apartments showing up over here. Now, there are many different styles of displaying this. For example, there are grid style, masonry style and etc. Now, I have selected this one, the carousel style. This, according to me, looks really amazing. We'll see how a single room looks like in a moment. After that, we have this section. You can see some features shown over here, like middle of downtown, great environment, free breakfast and so on. You can put in anything over here. I'll teach you how to do everything step by step. Then we have the testimonial section, which is also very important. And this section is also a carousel, as you can see. Then we have the gallery section. At the left hand side, we have our gallery. And at the right hand side, we have the recent post or recent news over here. Then at the bottom, we have the statistics section. Here, as you can see, we have served 2800 guests, 35,000 opening hours, 99.9% satisfaction and 100% will come back. Okay. Then we have the footer section over here. We have the cell phone number, the email address, the service or the sales email address over here, social profiles, recent news, our company icons, or you can put in your client's icon over here and a very small description about your company. Then at the bottom, we have the copyright message. Okay, so this was our homepage. Now let's see how a single room looks like. Okay, so this is how a single room looks like. At the top, we have this beautiful image over here. You can change the image, you can change the title from here. It's all up to you. Then we have this section. Here is the main image of this room. And at the left hand side, we have this reservation bar again. The person can reserve this room from here. Okay, he can select this options, how many nights he wants to stay and all these options. Then we have the features with different logos or different icons. For example, here, as you can see, we have the bedroom icon and here it says two bedroom. We have this user icon. Here it says four people maximum. Then we have this eye icon and here it says sea view. Okay, so we can use different icons to show different features. Then we have a small description or something written about this room and all the features shown over here. For example, the space, the amenities, the price and all these things. Then we also have the photos related to this room. For example, you can upload the view which you get when you get this room, the interior and all these things. Okay. Then again, we have some description about this room and at the bottom, we have the location and also we have the map over here. Okay, so this is how a single room looks like. You can also display all the rooms in this manner. As you can see here, you'll see all the rooms which are available on your website. Then we have this booking form over here. We'll create a different page for this process. Now this is a long process. We'll see this at the end. First, let's see all the different features that we get over here. Okay. Now I'll also teach you how to create a contact us and about us page, as you can see over here. Now I won't be wasting my time on and your time on creating a contact us and about us page. Rather, what I'll do is I'll give you some free layouts using which you can install and create these two pages within few minutes. And I'll also show you how you can make changes. For example, how you can change your address, your phone number and all your contact details over here. And here in the about us detail, I'll show you how you can change all this text from here. Okay. The main focus, our main focus in this video will be on working on the system, how the website works, how this booking works and all those things. Okay. How you see who has booked, how to accept payment and so on. Now, whenever someone books a hotel on your website or books a room on your website, they'll see a screen something like this. Okay, first let's see a demo. Let's see how this works and how anyone can book a hotel on your website. For example, this is the check-in form. Okay, so what I can do is I can select the check-in date, for example, 20th of April. Okay, and checkout date maybe 25th or 24th of April. Okay, now as you can see over here, automatically it is showing 4 nights. Now I can select how many rooms I want. So I just want one room and only for one adult. Now we'll see all the pricing strategies, how the pricing works. If you want, you can set different pricing for weekends and weekdays, and for special occasions like Christmas, New Year, you can have different pricing. We'll see all those things later on in this video in really detail, so don't worry about that. First, let's just see a demo website, how this system works, and after that you can decide whether you want to create this website or not. Okay, so you'll select all this option and click on check availability. Then you'll see all these rooms are available. Okay, and you'll see the price over here, for example, 300 per night and 90 per night. For example, I want this room. Okay, it is 2 king beds, maximum of 4 people allowed, and you also get a beach view. Okay, so this room looks really nice. So let's click on this, select this room button. Now you can add some extra features, but we have not done that, but we'll do that in the video. Okay, how to do that, we'll see that. Now let's click on go to next step. Here you can put in your name. So let me put some dummy name over here. Okay, email address, let us put some email address, some number over here. Fine. If you can also create coupons to give special discounts. Now there are 2 payment options available, PayPal and Stripe. Now I prefer Stripe over PayPal because you can make payment on your own website. The person doesn't have to go to some other website to make a payment. Okay, so we select Stripe over here and click on pay now. Now as you can see here, it will ask us for all the payment information. Now let us put our payment information over here, for example the card name, okay, card number, then CVC number and expiry date. Okay, now they can click on submit payment. Okay, as you can see it is loading, the payment is loading. Alright guys, now as you can see it says reservation is complete, and you also get these 2 email address and phone number. We'll see how to change these things. Okay, now let's see whether this reservation is updated on our website or not. Now as you can see over here guys, here the reservation is updated. We have this John Doe, the booking date is given, which is exactly at this time. Okay, the check-in date, check-out date, all you can, if you want to see the contact details, you can just click on over here. You'll see all the contact details, you'll see the phone number, the address, everything. You can see the payment details if you want. As you can see, the payment amount is $1,512. Okay, confirmation code, all this payment ID, everything can be seen over here. Okay, now here the status, it says paid online. Okay, so it's all up to you. You can select the, or you can accept the payment online, or if you want, you can accept the payment offline as well. Okay, now if this thing is done, if this thing is confirmed, you can just click on this link, which is mark as red, or you can just mark as pending, or mark, or just remove this thing. Okay. Okay guys, so this is how it works. This was a very short demo of how this website works and what is the website that you're going to create in this video. Now this is a perfect website for anyone who is trying to create a website for their hotel wherein they want to offer really cool features like booking online, accepting online payments and so on. So I hope you guys like the demo website. If you guys are excited and if you guys want to make this website, then stay tuned. Alright guys, so first, to create any kind of website, whether it be an e-commerce website, a social networking website, a simple blog, a business website, any kind of website, or especially these kind of website like hotel booking, a special type of website, any kind of website, you need 2 basic things, a domain name and a hosting account. Without these 2 things, we just cannot proceed further. Now a domain name is nothing but the name or the URL of your website. For example, google.com, youtube.com, all these things, blogdude.com, all these things are different domain names. Okay, so we have to register a domain name for our website. And the second thing is the hosting. Okay, if you see this website, all these images, all these codes, all these things, whatever details come on your website, for example, whenever someone puts in their detail, does a reservation on our website, all those different information and different data are saved somewhere. Okay, Now that is called a hosting, okay, wherein all the information is saved. Now all your website details or images, everything is saved in a hosting. Now hosting is nothing but a computer which is running 24/7, so that you know, whenever someone comes to your website, visits your website from any part of the world, your website should be running, okay? So that's why all your data is saved in a computer which is running 24/7. Now there are many different hosting providers out there in the market, but we'll have to select the one which suits our need. For example, the one which is the fastest and the most secure one. Now the one which is fastest is required because our website will be a bit different from other website. Other websites are really simple, they don't have this reservation options on that, and our website has this option, so it will be more heavier than the regular website. Okay, so for that we need a hosting account or a hosting provider that can give you better performance, okay? And we need a safe or a secure hosting provider, because here the person will come and they'll put in their credit card, debit card details. So we will need a very safe hosting provider for that, okay? So to get the hosting provider which I recommend, open a new tab and type in blogdude.com/tmd. Now this link is also given in the video description below. You can click on that link and you will be redirected to this page. Alright guys, so when you click on that link, you will be redirected to this page. Now here there are some discounts going on, but we don't want this discount because this is for shared hosting, and we don't want the shared hosting, we want the cloud hosting. So there is a button over here which says get into the cloud now. Click on that button. Now here if you see, there are three different plans available: Starter Cloud, Business Cloud and Enterprise Cloud. Now let's see very briefly what these different options are, what these different packages are, and why should you choose this hosting provider, TMD Hosting, over some other hosting provider. Okay, so let's see all the features that we get over here. So the first feature if you see over here is that it is using a 6-core CPU and 6GB of DDR4 RAM. Now just a few moments ago I have explained to you that a hosting is nothing but a computer which is running 24/7, and that computer has all your website files. So the computer which these guys are using is really, really amazing. This computer which these guys are using is using a 6-core CPU and 6GB of DDR4 RAM, which is really amazing. This will really increase the performance and speed of our website. Then after that, next feature is unlimited bandwidth. This is also a very, very important feature. Now bandwidth is the amount of data transferred through your website, okay? So unlimited bandwidth means that you can upload and download unlimited amount of data from your website, okay? So this is also a very, very important feature. After that, we have the most important thing that this company uses, which is the SSD space. Now this company doesn't use the regular HDD drive, which is really slower. They are using the SSD space, which is really, really fast. If you don't know about this, you can open a new tab and type in HDD versus SSD web hosting. You'll see all the results over here. There are many different articles written on that. You can read them all. You'll get a better idea. What I do is I always click on images so that we can see the result in, you know, visual form. For example, if you see over here, there are three different criteria given over here. The first one is speed, and the orange bar over here represents HDD and the green bar represents SSD. Now the first criteria over here is speed, and at the bottom it says higher is better. Now you can see the difference over here. SSD is just way more higher than the regular HDD. Now this is the speed. Obviously we want higher speed. Now sometimes SSD space is up to 30 times faster and higher than the regular HDD space which other companies provide. After that we have IOPS. Again it says higher is better, and you can see the difference is really insane. There is just no competition, no comparison between these two. Then we have the latency. This time it says lower is better, and you can see the difference over here. Here it is -4 or 4 milliseconds, and here it is 0.04 milliseconds. So you get a better idea with this that SSD is just amazing. It is just awesome. Okay, it will really improve the performance and speed of your website. Now not only that we get SSD space, we are getting unlimited SSD space. Because there are few companies out there in the market that do provide SSD space, but they don't provide unlimited SSD space. But TMD is offering unlimited SSD space, which is really, really amazing. Then we have unlimited website hosted. Now this is also a very, very important feature. Why? Because today you're creating this website, a hotel booking website. Tomorrow you might need to create some other website. For example, your business website, an e-commerce website, or maybe a simple blog. So again, you don't have to purchase a new hosting account for that. You can host that website, this website which you're creating. In fact, you can host unlimited website in one single hosting. Okay, so this is also a very, very important feature. Then we get a free domain when you sign up with any of these plans. We get premium support, free cPanel, NG, INX web server. Then we also get a SSL certificate. Now this is the SSL certificate if you see over here. This green socket, this is very, very important. Earlier it was not very important, but today it is really, really important. If you don't have SSL certificate installed on your website, now Chrome browser will say to any visitor who visits your website that this website is not secure. So that is not what we want. And SSL certificate is also required because here in this website, we require the user to put in their credit card details. Now, if you want these features to work on your website, then you need SSL certificate. If you don't have this certificate, then you won't be able to use that feature. Okay. So, this is very, very important. Not only that, we have SSL certificate, we have wildcard SSL certificate, which means that SSL certificates can be installed on unlimited number of domains and subdomains. Now this is really, really amazing because if you see the price for a single SSL certificate is basically $3,200. Okay, so you're saving hundreds of dollars over here if you're creating 4 or 5 websites, and if you install all SSL certificates on all the websites, it will cost you around $200-$300. But if you have this hosting, it won't cost you anything. Okay, so this is a really awesome feature. We also get optimum cache, which will improve the speed of the website. Then we also have memory cache instance of 256 MB. Performance is 3 times better than these two plans. And we also get a 60-day money back guarantee. Now there are 3 packages available. I would not recommend you to go with Starter Cloud. The reason is very simple because here you can host only one website. So suppose tomorrow if you want to create another website, you again will have to purchase a new hosting account. So that is not a good idea. You can go with Business Cloud or Enterprise Cloud. Now because I am using Enterprise Cloud, I'll go with Enterprise Cloud. So I'll click on this button which says Get Started. Now here you have to put in or enter the domain name which you want for free. Okay, for example, I am putting this domain name Nayeshik1. Okay, so this is the domain name which I want for free. After that, you can select the extension. There are many different extensions available like .org. If you're creating this website for an organization, you can select .org, .net. Okay, or if you're creating this website for a country specific, for example, if you're creating this website only for India, you can select .in. For UK, you can select .uk and so on. But for most of you people, I would recommend you to select .com because that is the most common and most trusted one. Okay, so put in your domain name, select the extension and click on proceed. Alright guys, now once you come over here, you have to put in some basic contact information like your first name, last name, email address, phone number and so on. Then after that, you have to put in the payment information, put in the card type, okay, your card number, CVV or CVC number, your expiry date. Now some of you guys might be watching this video from India. Now most of the Indians have that RuPay card. Now RuPay card is not accepted over here because that is only for domestic use. So if you want to make payment over here, you need to have this Visa or MasterCard. Okay, you can also make payment through PayPal if you want. Then after that, we have to select some purchase information. Like first thing is the data center location. Now this is a drop down. When you click on this, you'll see different option over here. Now you have to select the one which says nearest to you. For example, as you can see over here, Singapore says nearest to me, so I'll select that. Then after that, you have to select the period. So there are many different options available again, but the by default 12 month is selected. Now I also recommend 12 month. Now don't ever select this 1 month plan. The reason is very simple. You will have to pay $7 extra per month. Plus you will have to renew your account every single month. So that is not a good idea. Okay, so select the 12 month. Now after that, come at the bottom here, you have the promo code option. Now I have a code that will save you some money. So just type in Nayar7, N-A-Y-Y-A-R and numeric 7 and click on apply. Now as you can see, when you do so, this says this promo code gives you 7% off this purchase. Now this is very important because, you know, 7% is the highest discount that TMD offers on cloud hosting. So you are getting the highest discount possible. Once you do all these things, once you follow all my steps, just tick mark over here at the bottom and click on checkout. Now once you click on that checkout button, you'll receive an email from TMD Hosting which would look something like this. Now this is a very important email because it has all the important information regarding your website. It has your FTP username, password, your name servers, everything, all the important information that you'll need in the future, okay? So make sure you save this email somewhere, you take a printout, do anything you want, just make sure it is secured, okay? If you have multiple email addresses, just forward it to those different email addresses, okay? Now at the bottom, you'll see a link which says control panel link. Open that link in a new tab. Here you have to put in the username and password. So copy your username and password from here and paste it over here. Okay, once done, click on login. Now this is the cPanel. There are many different options available over here. Now we don't have to deal with any options over here. Just go at the bottom. And here under Softaculous app installer section, you'll see the first option is WordPress. Click on that. Fine, now click on install now. Now select the HTTPS over here or the HTTPS www. Make sure you have this extra S over here because if you don't have that, you will not get this SSL certificate. So to get that SSL certificate, we need to select the HTTPS one. Okay, now from here, select your website name. Okay, if you are creating this website for the first time, if you're doing this for the first time, you'll see only one domain over there. Now here in directory WP is already typed in, just delete that. Okay, now put in your site name. Now site name can be your business name or the name of your website. For example, for me it can be hotel booking website. And you can put in your site description. So your site description can be a very short, you know, you're describing your website in few words or your tagline of your website. Okay, so I'll just type in Vinayesh Sheikh. Now here you have to put in the username and password. Just delete this admin and just put in any username and password of your choice. Now after that, you have to change this admin email address and put in your own email address over here. Then go at the bottom and click on install. Now WordPress is getting installed on your website. It will take few seconds. Don't worry. As I said, it has taken few seconds. Now you get two different links over here. The first one is your website link and the second one is the dashboard link. Now open the second link in a new tab and let's get rid of all these things. Alright guys, so this is our dashboard, our cPanel. So what we can do is we can hover over here and you'll see this visit site option. Open this link in a new tab. So this is how your website is looking at present, okay? And this is the dashboard. Whenever you want to go to your dashboard, okay, this is the place from where we'll be controlling our website. We can create different pages, different posts, different hotels, and everything we can create it from here, okay? So whenever you want to visit this section, this dashboard section, just enter your domain name and put a / wp-admin, okay? Type in and you will be redirected to this page, okay? Now there are many things that I want to teach you, but we'll do all these things step by step. First, you'll see at the left hand side there are different menus over here. Now from there, there is an option called appearances. Click on appearances. Now if you see over here, there are three different themes already installed. Now if you don't know, if you're creating a website with WordPress for the first time, theme is nothing but the design of your website. For example, by default 2017 theme is installed. Okay, so this is how the website looks. This is the design of your website and theme has some specific features. Okay, so we don't need this extra theme. So first thing that we need to do is delete these extra themes. So click on this and click on delete. Again, click on this and at the bottom you'll see this delete button. Click on that. Okay. Now this is how our website is looking. Now we don't want our website to be looking like this. Okay, we want to create a website which looks something awesome like this and it has all these important and crucial features. Okay, so for that we need a different theme. So to get that theme, open a new tab and type in blogdude.com/hotel. Now this link is also given in the video description below. You can click on that link and you will be redirected to this page. Alright guys, so this is the theme that we'll be using to create our website. This theme is trending, which means people are really liking this theme. And this is the best theme which I found for, you know, creating this hotel booking website. So this is really an amazing theme. Now if you scroll down, you'll see all the different features which are available with this theme. Okay, all the different features. We can see everything over here, how your, you know, you have these overall features, the different payment options available, you know, popular gateways, you know, booking management, how it works. Okay, coupon codes, we can create different coupon codes, we can create different sliders, we'll see how to do these things. Okay, you get a pre-built or inbuilt good layers page builder, which really simplifies the work of creating a website, designing a website. Now this website is 100% mobile friendly, 100% mobile responsive. You can import things. Okay, it is also supported with WooCommerce. Now there are many different options available, many different features available. You can go through all of this. Now if you see over here, this theme has sold more than 5,000 copies. Okay, so this is really an amazing theme. Now you have to purchase this theme. Just click on this buy now button or add to cart button. Now I won't be doing that because I have already purchased this theme. Okay, so I'll just cancel this thing, come back over here. Now we have to install that theme or upload that theme. But before that, let's see one thing. Again, from the left hand side, there are different options, and amongst that option, there is something called media, hover media, and click on add new. Now when you do so, you'll see over here at the bottom, it says maximum upload file size is 2 MB. Okay, so you can upload any data, any file up to 2 MB. Now this is a bad idea because you might need to upload some file. For example, if you're uploading some good image, some good picture of the room or the hotel, and that is more than 2 MB, so that is a problem. First we need to fix this thing. We need to increase this upload file size. So that is very easy. First go to my website blogdude.com, or what you can do, there will be a link given in the video description below. Just click on that link and you will be redirected to that page. Okay, let us go to that post first. Okay, this is the one, upload file size exceeds and all these things. Okay, so when you go to this post, if you go at the bottom here, you'll see a few lines of codes, you know, five different lines of codes. Just copy it from here. Okay, now open FileZilla. And if you guys don't know how to set up FileZilla, there is a video on my channel. You can watch that video. It will help you in setting up your FileZilla account. Okay, this will be very helpful. Okay, now when you open FileZilla, you'll see all your file link over here. For example, the website which you are creating at present is hotel.nayashek.com. So you'll see a file or a folder with this name. Oh, okay, here as you can see, hotel.nayashek.com. Let's open this. And here there is a file, the first file, which is .htaccess. Now what you have to do, first you have to select a desktop from here. Okay, let us do that. Here it is. Select your desktop from here. Now drag this file to your desktop. Okay, it says transfer finished. Now let's go to our desktop. Okay, alright, as you can see, this is the file. Let's open this file. So this is how your file should look like. Now you have to paste in that code over here. Okay, now as you can see, I have pasted those five lines of codes over here. Now paste this code over here. Just press Ctrl S to save the file and cancel this thing. Now again go to FileZilla. Now what you have to do, you have to refresh this section. Okay, this section where you have your desktop, refresh this section. And again drag this .htaccess to your website folder. It will ask you to overwrite it. Select override, click on OK. Okay, as you can see here, it says transfer finished. Now let's see whether the thing has worked or not. So come back to your website. Let's refresh this. Now as you can see here, it says maximum upload file size 64 MB. Okay, so this is working fine. Now again, let's go to appearances. Now let's install or upload the theme which we have just downloaded. So click on add new button, click on upload theme, choose file, and choose the file which you have just downloaded. Okay, now let me show you. Okay, this is the file which you have downloaded. Now you don't have to upload this file. Okay, the file which you receive has many different things. Okay, first what you have to do, you have to unzip this file, okay, or extract this file. When you extract or unzip this file, you'll get a folder with the same name. Okay, for example, this is the extracted version of this zip file. As you can see, this zip file says Hotel Master package. Here also you have a Hotel Master package. When you open this, you'll see a new file over here, another zip file. Now here, this is the file that we have to upload. Okay, this is the theme file. So select this file and click on open. Okay guys, so the theme is getting installed on your website. You can see the progress in the bottom left corner of, if you're using Google Chrome, you can see the progress in the bottom left corner of your website. Now by the time the theme is getting installed, you can click on that red subscribe button and also press that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. Now that will take just 1 second of your life. Alright guys, now we have to activate this theme. So just click on activate. Now as you can see, this theme is activated. I think I have, let me zoom in a bit so that you can see much properly. Okay, now I think you guys can see everything properly. Now here there is a new message which says this theme requires the following plugins. Begin installing plugins. So click on this link which says begin installing plugins. So these are the different plugins that we need to install so that the theme works perfectly. Now what you can do, you can install one by one. For example, when you hover this, you get this install button, you can click on install. Or you can do one thing, you can just tick mark over here, it will select everything. Okay, and from bulk action, select install and click on apply. Okay, so it will install all the plugins one by one. Now as you can see, all the plugins are successfully installed. Now click on this button or link which says return to required plugin installer. Now we have to activate all the themes which you have just installed. So again tick mark over here and from bulk action select activate, click on apply. Alright, so we are done. We have installed and activated all the required plugins. Now click on this dashboard link. Now it will ask you to import the demo data, which we don't want to do because we don't want to fill our website with all the dummy contents, because that is not a good idea. Okay, so again click on this dashboard button just to get rid of that message. Okay, so this is your dashboard. Now if you see at the left hand side, there are many different features, new options available over here, like this Hotel Master, hotel option, rooms, hostels, and so on. Okay, now these are the different features that we'll be using to create our website. Now come to your website. Okay, come back to your website. This is how it was looking earlier before installing the theme. Now let's see what happens after installing the theme. So just refresh this page. All right guys, now as you can see, this is how it looks. Now let's start designing the theme. The first thing that we have to do first, let's get rid of this. The first thing that we have to do, we have to make this theme full width. Okay, as you can see, this is a full width website and this is a boxed layout website, which means that this the main section is boxed layout and we have something in the background. So we don't want anything in the background, we want a full width layout. Okay, so that is very easy. Come back to your dashboard, from the left hand side select Hotel Master. Okay, so the first option over here is container style and by default box style is selected. Now select this and select the full style and click on save changes. Now come back to your website and let's refresh this. Now as you can see, this has become full width, full layout. Now this is looking much better. Now let's start creating our website one by one or step by step. Now the first section, if you see over here, this is the header section. Now first we'll have to create this section. This is created using the master slider, which is master slider is a premium plugin, but we get it for free with this theme. Okay, so let's start doing this. Let's start creating this slider. So come back to your dashboard and from the left hand side, you'll see this option, master slider, click on that. All right, now click on this button which says create new slider. And here select custom slider and click on create. Now it will ask you to start creating these slides, but before creating these slides, we need to do some slider settings. Okay, so click on slider settings. Let's give it a name to this slider. Okay, so you can name it anything. For example, let me name it slider 1. Okay, then slider width and height. So first what we'll do is we'll select slider width as 1114, or just type in 1140. Okay, 1140. And slider height as 780. Okay, so this is the setting, or this is the height and width which I have selected over here in the demo website. Okay, so select that and put it over here. And from here, again here it is box layout, select full width and scroll down. There are many different options available over here, but we don't want anything enabled. just make everything off. Okay, now this is for slider. Now we are not creating a slider, we are just creating one slide over here. Okay, one slide. Now whenever you have many different slides, then these options are useful, like touch swipe navigation, mouse swipe navigation and so on. But here, because we are creating just one slide, these options are not necessary. So you can just make everything off, come at the bottom and click on save changes. Okay, now again come to slides and let's start creating this slide. Now if you see over here, there is an image used in the background, and there are many different images used throughout the website. Now all these images I am giving it for free to you guys. You will see a link in the video description below. When you click on that link, you will be redirected to my website. Let me show you that. Okay, you will be redirected to this link. Okay, this website link. Now here there is something, you have to unlock this thing. Okay, first to use the full the free images and different CSS which I'll be using later on in this video. If you want to use this thing, you click on this subscribe button. This thing will unlock and you will see a button something like this. Okay, download button. Open this and download this file. Once you download that file, you'll see a zip file something like this, media hotel booking website Nayashik. Unzip this file and you'll get a folder like this one. Okay, and in that folder you'll see all the images, all the CSS. As you can see, this is the CSS files. Okay, footer CSS, contact bar, sidebar, and all the images over here. Okay, now these are only for dummy use. Okay, for this is only for, you know, when you're creating a website for the first time and you don't have your own images and so on, so you can use these things, but don't use them on a live website, because some of these images are copyrighted, so I don't want you to get into trouble. Okay, so you can use this thing for development purposes, for creating websites, but don't use them on any live website. Okay, let's come back to your website. Fine, now what you can do, come back over here and click on add slide. Now you have to upload the file which you just selected, so click on upload file, select files, and let us see, here it is, this folder, and you have all these images over here. Now the image which we want to use is this one, slider one. Select this image and click on open. Now click on create slides. Now as you can see, this image is showing over here. Okay, so we have this background image. Now let's start adding this text one by one. Okay, so first let's add this text, which is this one. This is the best. So come back over here, and from here you have to select what you want to insert. For example, over here we have to insert this text. So we'll select text layer and click on this plus button. Okay, now as you can see, you'll get a new option over here. Now click on this text layer. When you do so, here at the bottom you'll get another option or some options related to text. Okay, so what text do you want to show? So we have to type in that text over here. So here, as you can see, here it says this is the best. So let's type in the same thing, this is the best. Fine. Now if you see on your website, here at the top it will show you this is the best thing. I don't know if you can see this, this is really small and the color is black, which is not looking good. Okay, so let's design this thing. So if you want to design this, you'll see this style option over here. Click on style and from here select this option, select style for your layer, and click on this select button. Now from here you'll see a demo of how it looks. Okay, you'll see a preview of how it looks when whatever design you make, this is how it will look. So first let's change this size. So let's make it 48 pixels. Now as you can see, the size is increased over here. So put in 48 pixels. You can select different fonts. There are hundreds of fonts available. Now the one which we want is Open Sans. Select this one and let's make it a little bit bolder. So when you select this font weight, you have different options. So select the 300 one. Okay, this will make it a little bit lightweight. Okay, because the one which we have used at the top is lightweight, and the one which we'll be using later on, this is the bold one, this is quite thicker one. So we'll be using this thing later on. First make it 300. Okay, it will look something like this. Now we can increase this space between the letters, so let us do that. Let us type 3 over here in letter spacing, 3 letter spacing. And let's change the color, because here the color is white. So let's select this one, text color, and let's select white from here. Now this thing has disappeared because the color is white. Now after doing all these things, click on apply style. Now, as you can see, this is how it looks. Okay. So what you can do is you can click on save changes. Now, I don't know why it is looking like this. Let us refresh and see whether the problem is solved or not. Okay. Now it is looking better. So if that happens, just refresh your website. Okay. Now, what we have to do, we have to make this thing center align. Now, there is an option over here at the top. If you see align to stage, if you want to make it center align, you can select this option. Okay. Horizontal center, select this. It will become center. And if you want to make it vertically center, you can select this option. Okay. But we don't want to make it vertically center. So let's bring this thing at the top. Okay. Somewhere between over here. Okay. So this is looking better. Now, after that, we have this small divider over here. So let's see how to add that. So for that, again, we'll need this text layer. So select this text layer and click on plus. Okay. Now select the top one, top layer one. And again, if you see over here, we have this option, lorem ipsum and all these things. Now just delete this text from here. Go to style. Now from here, put in the width as 100 pixels, or if you want to increase the size, you can do that. Okay. Put in the width 100 pixels and height as 4 pixels. Okay. Now select this button and select the background color and make it white. Okay. Select it and click on apply style. Now, if you see over here at the top, there will be a small divider. Bring this divider over here. Okay. So this is how it looks. Now, if you want to increase this, the size of this one, you can increase this. For example, if you want to increase it, let's make it instead of 100, let's make it 500. Now, as you can see, this is how it looks. Okay. This is how this will look. Now, if you want to increase this height, you can make it more bolder if you want. Okay. I think 100 was looking better. So select this. Okay. Make sure first this thing is selected. Okay. This divider is selected. So click on this and then you will get these options. Select the first one, go to style and make it 100 width. Okay. Okay. Much better. Now click on save changes. Whenever you do some changes to your website, make sure to click on that save changes button. Okay. So that you don't miss those changes, whatever happens to your computer, if the power goes up suddenly, so you don't miss any changes that you have made to your website. Now, after that, we have this text over here, room reservation website. So it says this is the best room reservation website. Okay. So let's add this text now. So again, select text layer, click on plus button. Now select this top section. Okay. And here, go to layer content and here it says lorem ipsum. Let's change this and let's type in room reservation website. Okay. Now go to style and click on select. First thing is that we have to change the text color. So you can select any text color, but throughout the website, I'll be using this color, this flat green color. As you can see throughout the website, you'll see this color. So you can select any color of your choice, blue, green, whatever color you like. Now this is the color which I like. So make sure you select your color and use that color throughout the website. Okay. So that this website looks a bit consistent and beautiful. So let me put in my color. Just type in this hashtag at the top, or what you can do is you can select your color from here, whatever color you like. You can just drag it, this thing here and there, and you can select this color. Or if you have your own color, like I have my own color, you can just put it over here. Put in this hashtag and type in 1ABC9C. Okay. So this is the color code which I want to use. Select this, click on choose. Now, as you can see here, the color is showing. Now let's increase this font size. Let's make it 80 pixels. As you can see, this is how it looks. Again, font, I'll select the same Open Sans, and font weight, this time let's select 700. Okay. Looking much better. Let's again add some space and let's add 4 pixels space between these letters. Click on apply style. Okay. So this is how it looks. Let's also make it center align. So again, click on this select, and here you have text align, select this, make it center and click on apply style. Now again, I want to make it, make sure this is center align. So select this and select this button. This will align it center. Okay. Now let's drag it at the bottom. Okay. Here. Okay. This is looking better. and again click on this button so that it remains center aligned. Okay, so with this we have added all the things that we need. Now what we have to do, we have to add some animations. Okay, let me refresh this website to show you. Now when you refresh this website, you will see some animations going on. As you can see, this is the animation which is going on. Okay, very short and sweet animation. Let's see how to add that. Okay, so first let's select the first text, the top text, come at the bottom and select transition. Okay, now select transition effect. What, there are many different effects available over here, you can select any one of them. Okay, so let us select this one, skew top. And if you want to see how this animation looks, you can just click on this play button. Okay, as you can see, this is how it looks. Now when you, if you want to increase the speed or decrease the speed, you can select it over here. As you can see here, it is duration. Now if I make it 5, it will become 5 seconds. Now this will increase, this will really reduce the space and it will really make it very slow. Let us see how it looks. Okay, as you can see, when I increase this to 5 seconds, the animation becomes very slow. So let's make it 1.6. okay, let's make it 1.6 and click on apply transition. Now as you can see, in the duration you will see 1.6. now there is another option which says delay. So when should this animation start? So I am putting 1.2 seconds. okay, so at 1.2 second this animation will start. Okay, now let's see a preview how it looks. Click on this play button. Okay, as you can see, at 1.32 second it has started, and you can see the animation as well. Okay, skew top. Now let's add animation to this divider and some other text. So let's select the middle layer one. This will select this divider. Now again go to transition, click on this select button, and for this one let's select let's see how this looks. Top long, not this one. Okay, right long, let's select this 3D front. Okay, this is looking better. 3D front long. Okay, select this again. Duration, let's make it 1.6. okay, click on apply transition, and for this one I want this to start after this one. Okay, so the delay for the first one was 1.2 seconds, and the delay for this one I want maybe 2 seconds. Okay, let's see how it looks. Let's see a preview. Okay, 1.2 second, it has started, and after that this is coming. Okay, looking better. Now let's add animation to the last text. Okay, so select this layer from here, again go to transition, click on select, and from this one let's select this one, 3D back long. Okay, this is how it looks. Again, duration, let me put 1.6. it's all up to you. I'm just putting 1.6 because I think that looks better. Okay, now click on apply transition, and delay for this one let's put 2 seconds. Let's see a preview how it looks. Okay, so this is how it is looking. I think this is really looking amazing. Okay, okay, so once you're satisfied with this one, just click on save changes. Okay, so with this we have completed this section, the top section, which is the slider section. Now let's add this section on your home page, and we haven't created any pages, so let's first create a home page. So again, come back to your dashboard, and from the left hand side you'll see pages, hover pages, and click on add new. Now let's give it a title of home. Okay, fine, click on publish. Let's open this page or view this page in a new tab. Now this is how it looks. There are many problems over here, we'll have to fix them one by one. Now the main problem is that when you see your URL bar, it says your website name slash home. We want to get rid of this slash home thing. We want to stay on the home page, but we want to get rid of this home thing, because whenever you go to google.com, you're just redirected to the google.com. You are not redirected to google.com/home or youtube.com/home. Okay, so first thing is that we have to get rid of this. So what we can do is, you can come back to your dashboard, and from the left hand side, hover settings, and click on reading. Now here the first option is your homepage display. By default, your latest post is selected. Now tick mark this thing, select this thing, a static page, and under home page select this and select the home which we have just created. Okay, now click on save changes. Again, come back to your website. Let's refresh it. Now as you can see, that home is gone. We are still on the home page, but that slash home is gone. Now let's get rid of this thing, okay, because this is not used in the demo website. If you see the home page, this thing is not used over here. Okay, so let's get rid of this. Okay, again, let's cut this thing. Okay, and let's open this link, edit page link in a new tab. Okay, so this is the edit page link. Let's scroll down, and here if you see show title, just make this thing off. Okay, make this thing off. Go at the top, update this page, come back over here. Let's refresh. Now as you can see, that thing is also gone. Now we have to start adding everything one by one. Now if you see this thing, this is the footer. We'll see these things later on after creating the home page. We'll see how this footer setting works, okay, and we'll see how to change this header and everything one by one, step by step. Okay, first thing, the slider which we have created, let's insert this slider on this page. Okay, so come back on this page. Now when you scroll down, you'll see different options over here. First thing is that we have to select a wrapper, and then we have to insert the content in that. Okay, first, obviously for the first time you will not understand that, but just follow my instructions, and as the video passes, as you see more of this video, you'll understand these things in a much better way. Okay, so first thing is that we have to select a wrapper. So to insert this thing, because this is a full size section, so we'll have to select the full size wrapper from here. So select the full size wrapper, click on this plus button. Now as you can see, one new option is added over here, which is this full size wrapper. Now inside this wrapper, we have to insert this slider. Okay, so again, it is very simple. Under this media item thing, select this thing and select this master slider and click on this plus button. Now you will see this master slider over here. Now what we have to do, we have to drag this master slider inside this full size wrapper. Okay, now let's not do anything further and click on update first. Now come back to this page and let's refresh it. Okay, it says invalid slider ID. Okay, not a problem. Again, come back over here. Now here you'll see this gear icon. This is to do some changes over here. Select this and make sure slider one is selected. Select this and click on save changes. Okay, now again, click on update. Come back over here. Let's again refresh. Okay, now as you can see, this slider is showing and we have this beautiful animation showing as well. Okay, now let's move forward. First, if you see that few things that are looking totally different. First is that this section is transparent, and here this section is not transparent. We have this white color border or white color background to this navigation. This is not at all looking good, but we'll fix these things later on. Okay, first we'll create this complete website, and after that we'll see those header footer things. Okay, now after that, let's create this section. Okay, the reservation bar section, a very, very important section. Okay, so again, come back over here, and if you see over here, the background color is a light gray color. Okay, this is the normal white color, this apartment section, normal white color background. But here in the reservation bar section, the background color is light gray. Okay, so we'll have to select this option, color wrapper. Okay, select this, click on plus. Now if you see, its color wrapper section is added over here, and inside this we have to add this reservation bar. Okay, so under this content slash post type option, select this and you'll see this option over here, hotel and apartment room availability. Select that one and click on plus button. Now again, if you see over here, just drag this thing under color wrapper, and without doing anything further, let's just update this page and let's refresh this page. Let's see how it looks. Alright guys, now as you can see, we have this thing over here. Okay, we have this section showing up over here. Now we have to do some changes over here. The first thing is that we have to put a title, then we have to change the background color, and we also have to change the color of this button. Okay, so let's start doing that. First, come over here and scroll down. Now to do some changes, as I said you earlier, you click on this gear icon. So let's click on that. Okay, here it says title type none. Let's select a title type. And here if you see, this title is center align. Okay, so let's select the type center align. Here it is, center align. Select this thing. Now put in the title whatever you want. So I'm just typing in check availability. Okay, now we don't have to do anything else. Just click on save changes. Now this will add this title over here. Now let's add this background color. Now because the background color is to the entire section, we'll click on this gear icon now. Okay, the color wrapper gear icon. Click on this. Now background type, make sure it is color. And background color, let's change this white color and let's put some gray color. You can select this light gray color from here. You can select any color from here. Okay, it's all up to you. Now what I'll do is I'll put in a code which is F5, F5, F5. Now this is a code for very light color. Okay, very light gray color. So select this thing. Now don't select anything else for now, or just click on save changes. Okay, and let's click on update. Come again over here, let's refresh. Alright guys, now as you can see, the background color is changed. We have the title over here. Now there are few changes still required. If you see in between this slider and this section, there is some gap over here. Okay, this wide gap, we need to get rid of this gap. Now this is some extra margin that we have over here. So we need to get rid of this gap. We need to change the color of this title, color of this button and all these things. Also, we need to add some gap at top and bottom of this section. Okay, the check availability section. Because as you can see over here, we have nice amount of gap over here at the top and bottom. Okay, so let's start doing everything one by one. First, let's get rid of this extra gap, extra wide gap over here. So let's click on this master slider. And if you see over here, we have this margin bottom 20 pixels. Just make it 0 pixels and click on save changes. Now select this full size wrapper and click on this gear icon. Again, scroll down, you'll see padding bottom. Instead of 40 pixels, make it 0 pixels and click on save changes. Okay, now this will remove this wide gap from here. Let us see whether that happens or not. Click on update. Come back over here, let's refresh it. Now as you can see, that white gap is gone. Okay, now let's add some gap at top and bottom for this section. Okay, so come back over here, scroll down and select this thing, this color wrapper. Now scroll down and here the padding top is 55 pixels. Let's increase this to 80 pixels and click on save changes. Okay, now again click on update. Now let's start changing the color of the title, the button and everything. Okay, so again come back to your website and here at the left hand side you'll see one option called master slider or hotel master. Open this hotel master link in a new tab. Okay, here it is. Now here again there are many different options. Now what we have to do, there is a feature in this website. You can create different skins for different designs, okay, or different sections. Now obviously when I say that you won't understand that, let me do it, you do it me and you'll understand it much better. Okay, so from here select this thing, elements color, and here at the top we have this custom skin. Before this, first again come back over here, let me explain you this. By default 4 skins are already created: dark skin, dark testimonial, light gray, dark header. Okay, so if you see over here, whatever section you select, for example let us select this color wrapper. When you select this section, you'll see this skin option and you have this 4 option given over here. Now let us add one more option according to our choice and let us design this section according to our choice. Okay, so let us add this section over here. Let us give it a name of maybe reservation. Okay, because we are designing the reservation bar. So let's name it reservation bar and click on this plus button. Now as you can see, one new option is added over here. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to come to this page. Let's refresh it. Now when you go, when you scroll down and when you select this color wrapper and when you select this skin, you will see a new option over here. Okay, we don't see that. Let's again try. Make sure you have saved. Okay, we haven't saved the changes over here. First save the changes over here, then come back over here. Let's refresh it. Okay, now again let's try color wrapper. Click on this gear icon, select skin, and here we have reservation bar. Select this thing, click on save changes. Now click on update. Now whatever color we put over here, that thing will be shown over here, okay? So the first thing that we need to do is change the title color, okay? So come over here, the first option is title color. Let's put in our own favorite color. So let me put in 1ABC9C. Okay, this is for title color. Now before proceeding further, let's see let's just put one thing, let's save and let's see whether this is working, okay? Now let's refresh and see. Okay, now as you can see, the title color is changed and everything has become white because white is the default color. Now let's change everything one by one, okay? Again, come over here. First, here if at the bottom, you'll see button background color. Now this is the same color, but button background color, so let's do that. Select this button background color, put in the same color 1ABC9C and copy this thing, not 8C9C, copy this thing from here and put it under the button border color and let's drag this thing a little bit down so that it, you know, we get this darker color over here. Now click on save changes. This will change the button color over here if you see. Let's refresh it. As you can see, the button color is also changed. Now we have some more thing over here like input text, okay? This text over here, inside text, and we have some text at the top. So let's change those colors. Again, come over here and here we have input text color. Select this. Let's select the black color or you can select some dark gray color that would look much better. Let's select this one. 3D, 3D, 3D. This would look much better. Select this. Click on save changes. Come over here. Let's refresh it. Now as you can see, the inside things are now showing. Again, come over here and this time button text color, we have white, which is fine, and icon color. Now if you see over here, there are few icons inside this bars. We have this calendar icon, we have this down icon, okay, down arrow icon. So we need to change the color for the icon as well. Here it is, icon color. Select this. Let's insert the same color, 3D, 3D, 3D. For dark gray or light black, whatever you can see. And what else we have? Content color. Let's select this thing, put in the same color. Okay, 3D, 3D, 3D. Okay, let me copy it so that we need any time. Let's save changes. Again, come over here. Let's refresh it. Now, as you can see, all the color are saved. Now, here we have this black color. Everything is looking so beautiful now, okay? Now, the great thing about it, this is that whatever changes you have done over here, now you can use this this skin unlimited number of times. Whenever you want to give any section a similar design, you can use this thing, okay? So, that is very, very helpful, okay? Now, within few minutes, if you see, we have already created two very important sections, okay? Now, we won't be going into detail now as to how this works, what are the process. We'll see the process at the end. First, let's create the home page and after that, we'll see the process, booking process, how it works, how to accept payments, how to do payment settings and so on, okay? So, the third section is this section. And before going proceeding further, because this section has all the rooms and we haven't created any room. So let's see how a room is created, how we can create a room. Okay. So come back to your dashboard and from the left hand side, you will see this option rooms and in bracket, you have hotel apartment. Click on that. Now you'll see that there are no rooms found because we haven't created one. Now let's click on this add new button to create one new one. And let's open any one of this. Let's open this one, penthouse apartment in London. And let's create, let's see how you can create this thing, how to add all this map, this gallery, all these different options, these icons and so on. Okay. So let's come over here. First, we have to give it a title. So here the title is, as you can see, here it is, penthouse apartment in London. Select this, copy it and paste it over here. Fine. Now, first, before doing all these things, we have to give it a category. So at the right hand side, we have this add new category. Click on that and let's add rooms. Okay. You can name it anything you want. So I'm just naming it rooms. Select this and let's select a featured image. If you want, you can select a featured image. Now this is what a featured image is. Okay. So come over here, select a featured image. Upload file, select files, and this file is also given to you in the video description below. Now let me see, I think this is the one. Select this, Okay, I think this is the one. Okay, 980 into 381. Select this, click on open. Click on set featured image. And before doing anything else, just publish this. Let's see how it looks. Let's open this link in a new tab. Okay, so this is how it is looking at present. We have this featured image, we have the title. Okay, so this is looking better. Let's see, let's proceed further. Okay, now after this, we have this thing. The first thing is that the pricing. Okay, what is the pricing strategy? So here it is $30 per night. It's all up to you. You can add any pricing you want. Now when you scroll down, you'll see here the page option. Under page option, room amount. Okay, how many room do you have? Okay, so for example, for this option, maybe we have two rooms. Okay, two rooms like this one, which is shown in this picture. Okay, at present, at one single time, two rooms are available, and in each room, how many maximum people can accommodate? So maybe four. Okay, so we have two rooms and each room has four, each room can accommodate four of maximum people. Now this is also a very important feature, block room on specific date. Now because we are setting some prices over here and we are allowing users to book the hotel or book this room, so we want to block booking this room on specific date. Now why is that important, or why is that even necessary? See, there are many different occasions like Christmas, New Year, or in India it is Diwali, Eid. So on these occasions, the price of the room is obviously higher because the demand on those special occasions are very, very high. So what we want to do, we want to block the reservation of these rooms on these specific days. And we want to, you know, increase the rate of booking on these particular dates. Okay. So if you want to block the room on one particular day, what you can do is you can type in the date. First, the year will come. So 2018, then the month will come, for example, December. So 12, then 25 for Christmas. Okay. So for Christmas, you'll type in 25, just type in 2018-12. -25. Okay, now if you want to increase this thing, or if you want maybe 7-8 consecutive days, then what you can do, you can put a space and then type in TO2 and 2018-12, or maybe let us type 2019-1 and maybe one. Okay, so from Christmas to New Year, this room will be blocked. Okay, and we'll put some special charges for whenever someone wants to book on this date. Okay, now what you can do, instead of using 2018, you can use this thing, asterisk sign. Okay, for both 2018 and 2019, whatever, instead of the year, you can put in the asterisk sign so that you don't have to do these things again and again each year. Okay, this thing, when you put this asterisk sign, this thing will be used each year. Okay, so this is a very important feature. Now we come to room price. Now this is the basic price, the base price. Okay, so base price for weekend, so let us put maybe $50, and base price for weekday, which is slightly lower, $30, and base price per guest. Now this is the base price for how many guests? Two. Okay, now whenever, because if you remember over here, we have the maximum accommodation of four, so this room can be booked by four people. So what we are doing is we are putting a base price of $50 and $30 on weekdays, weekends, for two people. And whenever the number increases beyond two, for example, instead of two, four people want to book, we'll have a different rate. Okay, let us see how it works. So this is the base, two people are base, and whatever is extra, we have to put in the rate over here. Okay, so this is the weekend rate. So for anyone extra on weekend, we'll charge maybe $40, and for children, we'll charge maybe $30. Okay, so this is for weekend. So for two people on weekend, it is $50, and anything about two people, three or four people, we are charging $40 for each extra person. Okay, I hope that is clear. Okay, and for weekend or for weekday, let us put maybe, alright, maybe let us put 40 for adult and 20, or maybe 30 for adult and 20 for children. Okay, so I hope this pricing strategy is cleared. I think I have explained it very clearly. Okay, everything is clear. Now here you have to put in the seasonal price. Okay, so click on this plus button. And again, you have to copy the same thing from here. So let's copy it from here, paste it over here. And in the season, we want to put all the prices the same price, maybe $100. Okay, so all the price will be 100, whether your base price, the adult price, children price, everyone will be charged $100 on that day. No concession, no nothing on that day. Okay, everyone will be charged the same amount. Okay, the base person, extra person, everyone will be charged $100. Fine. So this is how it works. You can add more seasonal prices. Okay, for example, this was for Christmas and New Year. If you want to add for Diwali, you can click on new plus button. You'll have this new bar over here and you can repeat the process. Okay, then you can also have discount for consecutive nights. Now for example, when someone is booking the room for one or two nights, it is a normal thing. But when someone books the room for 2, 3 or maybe 10 consecutive nights, then we want to give them some discount. So let's see how to do that. Click on this plus button. Now for 4, 5 and 6 consecutive nights booking, we want to give 10% discount. Okay, and we can add more. For example, let's click on this plus button again. And now for 7, 8 and 10 consecutive nights booking, we want to give maybe 20% discount, and so on and so forth. You can add more options over here. Now after this, we have this facilities and services thing. Now that will show up over here. Okay, it will show up the icon and the thing which you see over here. Okay, it will show up over here. Whatever you put over here, it will show up over here. Now the first feature is that it is a 2-bedroom room. So what we'll do is, first we'll select the icon from here. So click on this and select the bed icon, and here at the right hand side bar, just type in 2 bedrooms. Okay, and after that we have maximum people. So select this user and just type in 4 people. Okay, then we have the view. If this is this room has some special view like sea view or city view, you can just type in that. Then after that, room size, what is the room size? So let's select this home icon, and maybe it is 300 square foot, maybe, I don't know. So whatever it is, just select that. Okay, then Wi-Fi, does this room have a Wi-Fi facility? Yes, we do have this. So I'll select this Wi-Fi icon and select, just type in free Wi-Fi. Okay, then breakfast included. If you want, you can have this. Now there are only 8 icons over here. Okay, if you want some if you want to add some new icon, what you can do is you can go to logo maker, logomaker. Okay, it is not maker, it is just logomaker. Go to this website, and here this is a very beautiful and very useful website. You can have, there are many different icons you can choose from. So for example, if you want some icon for breakfast, you can just type in breakfast over here. Okay, and press enter. Now there's so many icons available. You can choose any one of these. You can color this, you can do anything with it. For example, let us select this one, a very simple one. Okay, all right. I think there's some problem going on with this website. Let's select something else. Yeah, I think there's some problem going on with this website. This is a very easy to use website. I don't know what is wrong with it. When you select that thing, a logo will show up over here. What do you have to do? You have to just save that logo. Okay, save that. Nothing to download. Okay, I don't know what is happening over here. Okay, maybe there is some problem going on over here, but it is really easy. Even if you don't understand that, although obviously you will understand that because that is really simple. But still, if you don't understand that, you can click on this button. Okay, here, and you'll see a video pops up, and it will show you how you can create a logo like this one. Okay, as you can see. Okay, this is how you can watch this video, learn how you can create it. Okay, so this is really simple, not any technical thing or so on. Really easy to do that. Okay, so you can download that logo and you can use it over here. For example, if you see this logo I have used in the demo website. Now this is not available over here, but I have created this using the logo maker, and I have used it over here. Okay, so it's all up to you. Now if you don't have this breakfast thing over here, what you can do is you can just click on this minus button and delete it. Okay, now we have airport pickup service. Yes, we do have. So I'll select this airplane thing and I'll just type in the same thing over here. Now I want to delete this feature as well. Okay, now before proceeding further, let's first update the page. Let's come back over here, let's refresh and let's see whether everything is working properly or not. Okay, now as you can see, everything is working just fine. Okay, we have all these ratings over here, the price, then we have the icons over here, the features, 2-bedroom, 4 people, whatever it is. We have the title showing over here. Okay, so everything is working just fine. Now let's see what we have next. Let's scroll down over here. Okay, we don't have anything over here. Now come at the top and let's start adding this main thing over here. So the first thing is very simple. This section is just some simple text, like you type in your Microsoft Word or something. Just type in some simple text and this is how you do it. And after that, we have these things over here. Now as you can see, there are different columns, different rows, and these dividers used over here. Now it is really, really easy to do so. We can use short codes and do all these things. Now let me show you how to do that. Okay, now first, if you see, there is this divider over here. Let's see how to add this thing. If you see over here, it says GDLR short code. Click on that and search for divider. Here it is. Click on this one. Now if you see over here, you'll see this thing. Now don't have to do anything. Just let's click on update. Let's see what happens when you do this. Come back over here. Let's refresh it. Now if you see over here, there is very thin divider. You can hardly see it. Okay. And this is 50%, which means that this is occupying 50% of the space. Now what we want is, first we want to make it thicker. And second thing, we want this thing to acquire the 100% space. Okay, so let's do that. Come over here. Now size, let's make it 100% instead of 50%. And type, instead of solid, let's type in thick. Okay, now again click on update. Come back over here. Let's refresh it. Okay, now as you can see, this is looking much better. Okay, this is really looking amazing. Now again come back over here. After that, we have this beautiful thing. Okay, we have 3 different columns over here. So this is also very easy to do. Okay, let's press enter to come on new line. Or what you can do, don't press enter, press shift plus enter. Okay, this is much easier way, and this is more professional way of doing it, because when you press enter, there you give a lot of space, and because there are some CSS HTML thing going on over here. Okay, so I would recommend you to press shift plus enter. Now we have to add these columns. Okay, so again very simple to do so. Just click on this shortcode thing and click on column. Here it is. Click on this. Now as you can see, everything is added automatically. Now we have this thing, first column text, second column text. So in the first column here, it says the space. So let's type in the space over here. Okay, let's type in the space. Also, if you notice, this is bold. So let's make it bold. Let's select the space from here. And okay, let's select everything. Okay, the space. And here we have this bold thing. Select this. Okay, now as you can see, it is bold. Now we have this column size 2. Okay, so second column text should come over here. Now instead of this, whatever you want. For example, here we have accommodation is equal to 4. Okay, let me copy and paste everything very quickly. Then after that, again, I did the same mistake. Don't press enter, press shift plus enter. Okay. Then after that, we have bathrooms is equal to 4. Okay. Again, shift plus enter. Then we have bedrooms 3. Okay, we have 3 bedrooms and 4 bathrooms. Okay, fine. I don't know. Just okay. Okay, bedrooms 3 and beds also 3. Okay, again, do the same thing. Now that first let me update and let me show you, and then after that I'll explain you further on. Okay, first let's update this thing. Come back over here. Let's refresh it. Okay, now this is how it looks. Okay, this is the first column and this is the second column. Now if you see over here, the first column, the short code here says size is 1/3 and the second one is says size is 2/3. Okay, now what we want to do is, we want to make the second one also 1/3. Okay, because we want 3 different columns of size 1/3. Okay, simple maths, not a difficult thing to understand. Okay, 3 different columns of size 1/3 will give us 1. which is one single row. Okay, now what I'll do is I'll copy this first column, okay, and I'll come below this thing, below this code, and press Control Enter and paste it over here. Now again, I have a new column over here with size 1/3. Okay, now here I have to paste in these things, check in time, checkout time, and all these things. So let me do that. Instead of this, let me type check in time. Okay, Shift Enter. Then we have the checkout time, whatever it is. Okay, then we have the property type, which is apartment. So again, let's paste it over here. Again, let's click on update, come back over here, let's refresh it. Okay, now as you can see, this is looking amazing. Now what we have to do, we have to add another divider below this, and then we have to do the same thing. Now I won't be doing the same thing again because I have already shown you how to do that, but let's add this divider below this. So we don't have to do anything, just copy this divider shortcut from here, go at the bottom and paste it over here. Now let's click on update, come back to this website, let's refresh it. Okay, so this is looking beautiful, but I have just noticed one thing, that below this divider, if you see below this divider, there is a lot of gap, there is a lot of space. Now if you're all right with that, if you're okay with that, no problem. But if you want to remove that, let me show you how you can do that. Okay, so here we have this divider shortcode. What you can do after that shortcode, press Shift Enter to enter on new line, and again click on this shortcode and search for space. Okay, now whenever you want to increase or decrease space, you use this shortcode. Now when you just, when you don't do anything, it will add more space, more 20 pixels, but we don't want that, we want to decrease space. So what we'll do is, before this 20 pixels, we'll just put a minus sign, really simple. So we want to minus 20 pixels from that space. Okay, do that, click on update, come back over here, let's refresh it. Now as you can see, our space is reduced and this is looking much better. Now you can use the same technique and you can create different things like this. Okay, now let me show you how to add this beautiful gallery. Come back over here, first click on this thing. Okay, come to new line and just type in photos. Let's make it bolder, so select photos and select bold. Again, come to new line, Shift Enter. Now we have to add this gallery. So let's do this again, select the shortcode and select gallery from here. Now you will see something like this. Now when you click on this, you'll get this pencil button, click on that. Now we have to select some files for your gallery. So let's select those files. Now in that folder which you have just downloaded, there is another folder which says gallery. Open that and select everything. Now there are 9 images. What I'll do is I'll deselect one because we want only one. So let's deselect this one. So we have 8 images over here, click on open. Now all those images are getting installed. Now if you see over here, we have 4 different columns, okay, and the size is quite small. So here you can select this, okay, number of columns you want, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2. So we want 4, so we have selected 4, and the size is thumbnail. If you want to increase the size, you can make it medium, large, full size, whatever you want, okay? But we don't want to do that, we just want columns 4 and size thumbnail. Click on update gallery. Now as you can see here, the thing is showing. Click on update again, come back over here, let's refresh it. Alright guys, now as you can see, this is looking really, really amazing. Okay, so we also have the gallery now. Now after that, again, there is some simple description, very easy to do. First, let me copy this code for this divider. Let me put it after this gallery. Alright, and after that, what we have, after that we have this thing, simple text, nothing to do, just simple text. So let's paste it over here. Okay, we have some extra gap over here. Now again, copy this divider from here and paste it after this thing. Okay, after this text, paste it over here. And after this thing, we have this location thing. Okay, now this is also simple text. Okay, so first copy this thing from here, or you can type in your own location over here, whatever, it's really easy, we know how to do that. Okay, just type in your own location over here. Alright, now after doing these things, click on update, come back over here, let's click on refresh button. Okay, so we have this simple text, we have our location over here. Now we have to add this map. Now let me show you how you can do that. First we'll have to create an API key. Okay, so what you can do is you can open a new tab and type in console.developers.google.com. Alright, now once you come up over here, I have already created a few APIs, but don't worry, I'll show you how to do it from scratch. First, obviously, you have to create an account, and if you don't have an account, if you have a Gmail account, then don't worry, it will just take you a few seconds to create a new account. Now, once you create a new account, you'll see this screen, and here at the top, you'll see something like this. Open this and click on this plus button. Okay, here you have this plus button, click on create project. Now you can name this project anything. For example, let me name it hotel project. Okay, you can name it anything. So I'm naming it hotel project and click on create. Okay, now once you do so, here as you can see, this thing is loading, this notification icon is loading, which means that your project is getting created. Okay, once it is done. Okay, yeah, now it is done. Now you can see one notification here. It says this project is created 5 seconds ago. Now when you see this option over here, click on again. Now you don't have to create anything new. You have this thing over here. Okay, hotel project. Select this thing. Okay, now once you do so, you should see hotel project at the top. Now we have to enable some APIs. So click on enable APIs and services. Now search for Google Maps JavaScript API. Okay, here it is. Select this thing. Click on enable button. Alright guys, so the API is successfully created. Now it says to use this API, you need to create credentials. So click on this button which says create credentials. Now select Google Map JavaScript API from here and click on what credentials do I need. Now here is your credential, but still you cannot use it right now. What you can do is you can just click on this done button. Now first you'll have to add your domain over here. So go to domain verification and click on add domain. Now put in your domain over here. So our domain is hotel.nayashek.com. So let's copy this domain, paste it over here, click on add domain. Okay, now it is automatically added, but for you this will not happen. Okay, let me show you what will happen for you. Let me add some other domain. For example, instead of hotel 2, let me select hotel 3, 4, something like this, which does not exist. So I'm just putting hotel 3 just to show you how it will work for you. Okay, so I'm putting this thing and you put in your domain name, click on add domain. Now they will ask you to verify your ownership. Now you have to click on take me there. And again, click on add property and again, put in the same domain name over here. Click on continue. Now here you'll get a HTML file. As you can see, it says download this HTML file. When you click on this link, this HTML file, you'll get this file. You'll download this file. Now you have to upload this file on your website folder using FileZilla like we have did earlier in this video. Okay, so it is really easy. Let me show you how to do that. Open FileZilla and go to your website folder. Here it is, hotel.nayashek.com. And search for that file. Okay, let me search. Okay, here it is, Google file. This is the file which we have just downloaded. Drag this file on your website. Okay, on your website folder. Now it will ask me to override because I already have this, but you don't have it, so it won't ask you anything like this. Okay, so I'm overwriting this. Now once you're done with this, click on I'm not a robot. Now this is not going to work because this is just a different domain name, but I have just shown you how you can do this. Okay, now once you do so, once you click on this verify button, it will verify it. And again, you have to come over here and put in same domain name, click on add domain, and this time it will accept your domain name. Okay, so it is a really easy process. Okay, don't worry. Now click on credentials and copy this API key from here. Come to your website and from the left hand side, you have this Google Maps. Hover Google Maps and click on settings. Now here you have to paste in the API key which you have copied and click on save settings. Now once you do so, we have to add the location. So first again under Google Maps, you will see this option add location, click on that. Now let us type a location title. Now what is this location title? Let me explain you this. If you see this marker over here on this map, when you click on this marker, we get all these things, Block Dude Incorporation Mumbai 1. Okay, so this is what your location title is. So I'll just type in Block Dude Incorporation. Okay, I already got this option. Now location address, I will not put in the complete address, I'll just type in Mumbai. Now we have to put in the latitude and longitude. Now if you want to know your latitude and longitude, it's really really easy. Again, open a new tab and type in latlong.net. okay, and put in the place name which you want. For example, let me put in Mumbai. So let me find in, so here is the latitude and longitude code. Copy the latitude code, come over here, paste it under latitude. Copy the longitude code, paste it under longitude. Okay, really easy to do that. Now put in the city, the state, okay, your postal code, fine. I have already done that, that's why it is saved, you know, Chrome saves some data. So that's why I was able to do that thing. Now info window is where what you want to see over here. Okay, for example, here it says Block Dude Incorporation Mumbai 1. So whatever you put over here, whenever someone clicks on this marker, this is what it will show. So let us put the same thing, Block Dude, or maybe let us not put some, let's put something else, Hotel Master, okay, Mumbai, fine. Now after doing all these things, just click on save locations. Now once you have created a location, we can create a new map to show over here. Now really easy to do that. Again, click on this button under Google Maps, you have add map, click on add map. Give it a title, I'm giving it Block Dude Incorporation. Map width, don't put anything. Map height, just put 380, okay. Map zoom level, put something like 14, 12, something like that, okay. Now don't do anything, just scroll down and select this thing which we have created, the location which we have just created. Select this thing, come at the bottom, click on save map. Now once you do so, again under Google Maps, you will see this option, manage maps, click on that link. And here at the extreme right, you will see the shortcodes. Copy this shortcode from here, come back to this page. Okay, let's edit this room, let's edit this room in a new tab. Okay, so we want the map at the bottom, so go at the bottom and below this thing, paste the map code over here, click on update, come back to this page, let's refresh it, let's see. Okay, now as you can see, we have this map over here. When we click on this, it says Hotel Master Mumbai. Okay, so I hope it was helpful. Now this is how we do it. Let's see whether anything, okay, this is left. If you want to change the this image, let us see how to do that. So again, come back over here and you have this thing, header background image. So let's select this header background image, upload, let's upload an image, let's upload this one, let's see which image is here. Okay, we have some different image, so let me select that, let me upload that image. I think we have let us see, let's select this one. Okay, select this, click on open, click on upload, update file, come back over here, let's refresh it. Okay, as you can see, that thing is done, but there is a problem, we don't see this thing because that is black color and we want to make it white color. So again, come back to your dashboard, click on Hotel Master. Now come back over here and here again under element color, select body. Now in body, if you see over here, here we have the heading color, select this heading color, make it white. Okay, yeah, I guess that is the one, select that heading color, make it white, click on save changes, come back to that page and refresh it. Okay, now as you can see, the color has changed. Okay, now we have this white color over here. You can change this color to anything you want. Obviously, it's all up to you. Okay, guys, now we have seen how to create a room. Now let's proceed further. Obviously, we want to change the color of this thing, but we'll do this thing later on. Okay, we have created a room. Now again, let's get rid of all these things. Again, come back to the home page. Okay, again, let's cut this thing. Here is our home page. Let's edit this page in a new tab and let's start adding some more options. Okay, further options. Okay, let's see what we have next. So we have this thing, we have the carousel showing up over here, room carousel. So let's add this thing, come over here. The first thing is that because we have this white color in the background, nothing else. So we'll select color wrapper, click on plus. We have this thing over here. Now what we have to do, we have to insert these hotels and apartments which we have created. Now from content post type item, select this thing. Okay, hotel room available. No, not this one. Here it is, hotel and apartment room. Okay, select this, click on plus button. Now drag this thing over here. Now click on this gear icon to make some changes. First is title type. We do have a title over here, left align title, which says our apartment. So first we'll make it left align. Let's put a title, and we have a title link text. Okay, as you can see, we have a title link text which says view all rooms. Okay, so we also have view all rooms, and in the link URL you have to type in your website name. So let's make it our website name. Okay, not this one, our website name is hotel one. So type in your website name slash room. Okay, ROOM, room. So do that and make this carousel yes. Okay, and change the room style to new medium thumbnail. Okay, number to fetch, how many numbers do you want to show, and excerpt is the amount of content you want to show up over here. Okay, so we want to show a limited amount of content, so 20 is fine. Now thumbnail size, select this one. It is room thumbnail. Select the room thumbnail, and rest everything looks fine. Click on save changes. Okay, we have everything over here. Yeah, we have everything. So select save changes and click on update. Now again, come back to this website. Let's refresh it. Let's scroll down. Okay, so this is how it looks. Now again, let's change the color of this one. Let's make it exactly like this one. Very, very easy to do. Again, come back over here. We have this hotel master. Open this link in a new tab. Now again, from element color, select element color. And from here, select room color. Okay, here it is, room color. First thing, single room title color. Okay, so what is the title color? Whatever you want to make. So suppose you want to make, here it is blue. But let us make the same color, this green color. Okay, so let us put the same color, 1ABC9C, looking better. Let me copy this because we'll be needing this more times. And what else we have after that? We have item room, item title color. No, we want to, let's change the button color and this price color. Okay, we also have to change this color, room item title color. Okay, this is the one. So let's select this room item title color. Let's put the same color and title hover color. So when we hover this, let's make a bit darker. So I'll select the darker shade. And then price color, let me put in the same color. And what else do we have? Here we have only these things. So let's click on save changes and let's search for button. Okay, so we don't have the button over here. Just click on save changes first. Let's refresh it. Okay, now as you can see, most of the things are working. Here we have this thing, we have this thing over here. Again, come back over here, we have missed few more things. Now first go to content elements. Okay, let's change the button. Let's find button over here. Here it is, button background color. Now put in the same color, button border color. Again, put in the same color, just select a darker shade. Okay, and button text color is white, which is fine. So select these things, click on save changes. Again, come back over here, let's refresh it. Okay, so button thing is also changed. We have to change the title color, which is here at the top. So let's see. I think that will be under body. So let's select body from here. Okay, now we can select this body background color, body title color. Okay. Alright guys, I think everything is looking fine. Now let's move forward. Let's create this section, a very easy section again. Okay, so again, let's come over here. Let's get rid of this. Come back to this page. Let's scroll down. First, if you see in the background, we have an image. So this time we'll have to select a different wrapper. So this time, let's select this one, background parallax wrapper. Select this, click on plus button. Here we have this thing. And inside this, we have to create three different columns. As you can see, this is the first, second, third column. So come at the top and select 1 by 3 and click this plus button 3 times, 1, 2, 3, okay? Okay, so we have these 3 items over here. Drag all these things one by one at the top. Now inside each of these columns, you have these column elements. So again, come at the top. From this content or post type item, select this thing, column service, and click on plus button 3 times. Now let's grab this service one by one inside this. First, let's put this image in the background. So let's select this thing, background section. Make sure her type is background image and select this image, upload this image, upload file, select files. Let's search for that image. All right, I think here it is, I guess. Yeah, this is maybe, yeah, I think that is the one. Let's select this, click on OK. No, that is not the one. This is not the one. Again, click on upload. Upload files, select files. Let me search for that one. Okay, this is the one. Hostel service BG, hostel service background. Select this, click on open. Okay, here it is. Select this, click on upload. And at present, we don't want any skin, but we'll change this skin. Padding top and bottom, let's increase this. Let's increase this to 95. And bottom is fine, 40 pixels. Just click on save changes. Now select this column service, click on this gear icon, and media type, we want image. As you can see here, images are used, not icons. So let's select this image, let's upload this image, upload files, select files. Let's select 3 services from here, click on open. Okay, let's select this one, click on upload. Title, as you can see here, it says middle of downtown. Select this, click on, or just paste it, item style, center align round thumbnail, select this one, okay. Content style, okay, let's copy and paste it over here. Now whenever you copy and paste something like this, put it under text section, okay. Now bottom margin, let's increase the bottom margin to maybe 60-65 pixels. Click on save changes, okay, let's update this page. Let's come over here, let's refresh it. Okay, now as you can see, we have this background image, we have this thing showing up over here. Now similarly, you can create unlimited number of these services, but I won't be doing that because I have already shown you how to do that. Now let's change this style, okay? So what we can do, we can create a new style for this one. So let's do that. Again, come over here, let's open this Hotel Master in a new tab and click on this elements color. And custom skin, let's add a new one called services. Click on this plus button. Okay, now very simple, we have to do only 2 changes, the title color and the content color. Okay, so the title color is the same color which you have selected throughout the website, and the content color, let us see, here it is, the content color is white, which is fine. Just click on save changes. Okay, now come back to this page, let's refresh it, go to that section, here it is, background parallax section, click on this gear icon, and from this skin, select this services skin, click on save changes, let's update and see the changes, let's refresh it. Now as you can see, only 2 changes have done all the settings over here. Now this is really looking awesome, okay. Now let's move forward and create this testimonial section, very easy to do so. Again, come over here on this page. Okay, here again we have this color background, as you can see. So we'll select color wrapper from here, select color wrapper, click on this plus button, and from here select testimonials, here it is, click on this plus button. Now we have the color wrapper, drag this testimonial under that, select the color wrapper, and let's add some background color over here. So let's add 01ABC9C. Okay, we have the background color. Let's add some padding at top and bottom. So let's add 80 pixels at top. Click on save changes. Now select this testimonial thing. Let's add a new testimonial. Author name, here as you can see, here it is, Angelina Cole. Select this. So this was the image, I'm sorry. We don't have any image over here. So I'll just select the author name. Position, let's make a traveler. Okay, and content. Let's copy some content, dummy content from here, paste it over here. Fine. Now title type, it is center align. Okay, as you can see, the title is at the center, which is testimonial, and type in the title over here. Then testimonial column, we just want one single column, and style, make it carousel, because as you can see, this is carousel. Then after that, we have a testimonial style. We have this, select this one, large plain style. Okay. And margin bottom, let's add something like 60 pixels and click on save changes. And obviously you can add more more thing over here. From just click on this plus button and you can add more testimonials. Okay, now go at the top, click on that update button, come over here, let's refresh this page. Okay, as you can see, this is how it is looking. Now again, we have to do some changes. Now this is going to be a very simple change, because everything here is white, so we don't even have to do anything. Come over here, let's create a new skin. Let's call it testimonial. Okay, click on this plus button. Okay, here, let's see, here it is, testimonial. Everything is white, don't do anything, just click on save changes. Come over here, refresh this page and select this color wrapper, select this skin, select testimonial, click on save changes, click on update. Come over here, let's refresh it. As you can see, this is looking amazing. Just change this color, okay, the background color for this icon. Let's see how to do that. And here we have icon color, here it is, icon color and element background, or maybe I think it is element background. Let's see, let's paste in, okay, let's paste in the color 1ABC9C. Let's see what happens. Click on save changes, come back over here, let's refresh it. Yeah, that is what it was, element color. Now that is gone. Okay, so we are done with testimonial section as well. As you can see, it is really easy to do do these things, really easy to do. Okay, now we have this section. This section is very easy again. We can easily create this gallery section, and after that we have to create this post section. Now if you're using WordPress for the first time, let me very quickly show you how you can create a new post. It is really easy. Okay, so whenever you want to create a new post, you select this post from the left hand side, hover post, and click on this add new. Okay, and you put in any title of your choice. Okay, for example, let's open this post. Okay, let's copy the title from here and paste it over here. Okay, not this one, here it is, the post, paste it over here. Now this is same as Microsoft Word, so you just type in anything, you make it bolder, you add all these things, you know, bullet list, you make it center align, left align, you add block codes. Okay, like this one, if you see over here, let me show. As you can see, we can add some block codes, whatever you want to type, and you select this thing, you select this block code, you'll have this kind of thing showing up over here. And here also in post, you can use these shortcodes. Okay, if you want to make any column, if you want to use any icon, any portfolio, whatever you want to do, if you want to add some divider, whatever you want to button, according box with icon, whatever you want, you can use these codes here as well. Okay, but what I'll do is I'll just copy some simple text from here and paste it over here. Now you have to add a new category. Okay, so we'll click on add new category, and let's select maybe technology. Maybe this post was related to technology, so this is the one. And you can add a featured image, so let's select featured image, let's select this one, set featured image, click on publish. Fine, so this is how easy it is to create a post, really simple. Okay, there is nothing to teach over here. Let's cut this thing again, come over here, let's add this section. Let's come back to this page first, let's add this section, very easy. First, what we have to do, we have to add a simple color wrapper. So let's add a color wrapper, click on plus button. Now we have to add two different columns, half plus half. So let's select this one, half column, press this plus button two times, come over here, drag both this column at top. Okay, now inside the first one, we want this gallery. So let's grab this thing. Gallery will be under media items. So select gallery from here. Click on plus button. Here it is, gallery. Let's select this. Now click on this gear icon. First, do you want title? We do want title because as you can see over here, we have the title and we have this divider. Okay. So we'll select left align with divider. Put in the title. Okay, now when you scroll down, you'll see this thumbnail size. Select this and select this one. Small grid size 4, which is 400 into 340. And gallery style, which is a grid gallery, which is fine. And make this thing on, which with featured. Now when you make this thing on, as you can see, one image is the featured image. It is a bigger one and rest everything is smaller one. Okay. Now image columns 4, everything is fine. Just click on save changes and let's first refresh it. Click on update, come back over here. Let's refresh it. All right, guys, we did not add any images over here. So let's do that. Select this gear icon, click on add images and again, go to gallery, select files, select this gallery, select everything, click on open. Let it load and upload. All right, now click on add images, scroll at the bottom, click on save changes, come at top, click on update and come back over here. Let's refresh it. Okay, so we have the gallery over here. We'll change this color, change the color of this divider in a moment. Okay, first, well, let's create this section, the block section. So again, come back over here. Now add a new content type and select block from here. Click on this plus button and bring this block under column item 2. Now click on this gear icon. Again, we have a title left align with divider and the title says news from us. Okay, so select this, put in the same title and we have, you can select which category to show. If you don't select anything, all the categories will show. Okay, now excerpts, you can increase or decrease. So let's make it 20 or maybe 17. Number, how many number you want? We want only 3 posts to show. As you can see here, only 3 posts are showing. Okay, and here we at the bottom we have read all news. So what you can do is you have read all news over here, and in the title link URL you can put your website name, or this is my website URL. Put in your website URL slash blog. Okay, do this and come at the bottom. Block style, select the first one, block widget. All right, rest everything is fine. Click on save changes. Let's again update this page, come back over here. Let's refresh it. Fine, so we have created 2 blocks. This hello world is already created and this is the one which we just created. Now let's change the style. Let's change this color of this divider and color of these things. Okay, this date thing. Okay, so again come back over here on this page, on this option, hotel master, and from the left hand side select this block color. Okay, now let's see what we have. First thing that we have to do, or maybe the only thing that we have to do, is this the date background and date border. Okay, let's search for that. Here it is, block date background. Let's put in our color, which is hashtag 1abc9c. Copy it and paste it under this. So let's see, this is block date background and block date border. We should have something like this. I think this is the one. Shadow, and let's darken this. Let's click on save changes. Let's refresh this page. All right, so this is looking awesome. Now let's change this color, this divider color, and this link and link hover color. Okay, so let's see how to do that. Come over here. First, to change the divider color, click on body and let's search for divider. Okay, here first we have this link color and link hover color. First, let's change this, put in the color under link color. Now this is obviously this thing over here, link and link color. Now select the link hover color. Let's make it a little bit darker. Let's search for divider. First, let's save the changes. Come over here. Let's refresh it. Okay, this thing is now changed. Now again, come over here. Let's search for divider. I think they call it something different. Let me search. Background body, container background. Here it is, item title divider. Select this, put in your color over here and click on save changes. Again, come back over here. Let's refresh it. Okay, fine. Now this is also looking perfect. Now let's create the last section of this page, a very, very easy section. Okay, let's see how to do that. Again, come back over here. Obviously, we'll be using this thing, this background and parallax wrapper, because we have a background image. So let's see how to do that. First, let's select this thing, background parallax wrapper, click on plus button, and we have four different columns over here. So first, what we'll do is we'll select 1x4 and click on this plus button four times. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now let's scroll down. Let's bring all these things under over here. Let's do that. Fine. Now if you see over here, there is a lot of gap at top and bottom. So first, let's do that. Click on this gear icon. Let's add the background image. Click on upload file, select files, and let me search what image is that. I think it is this is the one, I guess. Select this, click on open. Let me see. I don't know. Okay, well, whatever it is, just select a dark background. Select this, click on upload. Now scroll down. Now scroll down. And here it is. Let us increase the padding top to 190 and padding bottom to 120. Click on save changes. Now we have these stats under this thing. Okay, so let us search for stats over here. Okay, under content slash post, let's search for statistics or stats. Okay, I think it is called skill bar, I guess. Select, not bar, skill item, I guess. Let's see. First, let's select skill item. I think that is what it is. And click on plus button. Let's bring this thing under the first column. Click on this gear icon. Style, just normal. Okay, let's see. Okay, title is 2800 and caption is guests. Okay, so let me copy this, paste it over here, click on save changes. And what I'll do is, because here also everything is white, and if you remember in the testimonial section, everything is white. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll select this thing and we'll select this testimonial skin, because here also everything is white, so we can use this thing. Click on save changes, click on update, come back over here, let's refresh it. Okay, that is what it was, skill items. Okay, we have this background image, everything is looking white and it is looking really awesome. Okay, so with this we have completed the home page. This is how you create the home page. Now let's start creating the footer. Okay, so come back to your website, come back to this page, hotel master options, and from here select this footer. First thing is that we have to change the footer background, and let's make it black. So the color which I have used is 1E1E1E, which is almost extreme black. Now because the background color is black, most of the thing should be white. Okay, so we'll select this text color as white. Okay, footer text color as white, and footer text link as well as white, link hover as white. And footer border color, let's see whether we have any border color over here. Okay, we don't have anything like that, so we can just leave it. Okay, then footer input box border, copyright top border, copyright text color. Okay, I think, okay, copyright background is this bottom footer. Okay, let me show you over here. As you can see, this is the bottom footer. We have this copyright section, this is the bottom footer. So bottom footer color also we want the same 1E1E1E, and the text and everything over there will be white. Okay, okay, let's not make this white. Click on save changes. First, come back over here, let's refresh it. Okay, so this is how it looks, looking much better. Okay, we need to get rid of this thing. Okay, let's do that. I think it was this one, footer border color, I guess. Let's make it 1E1E1E. Click on save changes, come back over here, let's refresh it. Okay, not that. Then maybe copyright top border. Okay, so select this 1E, 1E, 1E. Click on save changes. Come over here, click on just refresh it. All right, that is gone. So that is what it was. Now let's change the footer. The first footer, if you see over here, this is the simple text. Then we have all the recent news or recent post, and then again we have this footer section over here. This is really, really easy. In fact, you don't even have to do anything. I have some thing for you, okay, that will really help you. So first come back to your dashboard again, and from the left hand side you'll see this appearances, hover appearances, and click on widgets. Now in the footer one, you'll see there are many options which we don't need. Just delete everything which you see under footer one, delete everything. All right, now from the left hand side you'll see this text section. Select this text section and make sure footer one is selected. Click on add widget. Now go to that file which you have downloaded, and in that file you'll see this thing, footer CSS. Open this. You have footer 1 CSS and footer 2 CSS. Okay, so this is the footer 1 CSS. So this is the footer 1 CSS. Just copy everything from here, copy it, select it, everything, select everything from here, copy it. Now come back to your website and paste everything over here under the text section. Okay, paste it, click on save, and let's give it a title. For example, here the title is book now. So let's give the same title over here. And obviously if you want, and you will have to change this thing. For example, if you want to change your number, instead of this dummy number 1800333322, whatever it is, you can put in your own number. For example, here it is. Okay, so you can put in your own number like 123, what are all these things. And instead of this email address, okay, you can put in your own email address. It's really easy. Rest you don't have to do anything, just click on save. Let's minimize this thing, come over here, let's refresh it. Okay, now as you can see, this is looking awesome. Okay, now again in the second widget we have to do the same thing. Okay, no, we don't have to do the same thing, we have to put in some recent post. Okay, so let us search for recent post. Here it is, select recent post, make sure footer 2 is selected, click on add widget. Now let us give it a title of recent news. Okay, so let's copy it, paste it over here. How many recent posts do you want to show? So maybe 5. Click on save. And in the footer 3, again we have this image and some simple text. So come over here, again search for text. Now select footer 3 and click on add widget. Now if you want to add some image, just click on this add media and add that image. Okay, so let's see, I don't think we have this image over here, but you can add this image from here. Let us add some, we don't have any such image, so let's upload this. Now if you want to add some image, just click on this add media. Let's upload some image, because at the top that was an image. Let us let me show you again. Okay, this is the one. Let's select this, click on open, click on insert into post. Okay, this is how it looks. And after that we have some text, so let's type in the text, or just copy this text from here and paste it over here. You can type in your own text if you want, and let us give it a title of, okay, we don't, it does not have any title, so just click on save. Come back over here again, refresh it. Okay, looking amazing. Okay, so this is how it looks, and this is how you do all these settings. Okay guys, now let's change this header settings. Okay, let's make it transparent, let's change this logo and all these things. So again, very easy. Come over here, under overall elements you will see top bar. First we have to get rid of this top bar. At the top you see you have this address or something, you have this social icons over here. So in the demo website we haven't used anything like that, but if you like this thing you can keep it, but we haven't used it, so we'll just make it off. Click on save changes, let's refresh it. Now as you can see, that is gone. Now let's get rid of this section. Okay, so select this header logo, left logo, and header style, instead of solid select transparent. Make enable float menu off or on, it's all up to you. And under upload header transparent logo, click on upload. Upload files, select any transparent logo if you have. I have over here logo hostel, select this, click on open. Click on save as logo. Now logo width, make it 190. top margin, make it 50, bottom margin 20. And again, over here, top margin 20, bottom margin, top margin 50, top bottom margin 20. Click on save changes. Come over here, let's refresh it. Okay, now as you can see, this is also looking really nice. We have this logo and this is really looking amazing. Okay, now we need to add some menu over here, but we'll do those things later on. First, what we'll have to do is we'll have to color this reservation bar. Let me show you this bar. Okay, let's color this thing first. So again, come back over here under this color settings, click on element colors, and from the left hand side, select reservation bar. And let's change the background. So let's make it our favorite color, 1ABC9C. Copy it. Okay, this is the background color. Then reservation header border. If you see, this is the border. Yeah, I don't know if you can see this. There is a thin border over here. So what I'll do is I'll paste in the same color and select a darker shade. Okay. Then what we have, let us see whether we have the button thing. Okay, here it is, reservation bar button background. Again, select the same color. Okay, no, not the same color. Okay, put in the same color, but select a darker shade. Okay, and border color, put in the same color, but more darker shade. Fine. Okay, for now, this is it. Click on save changes. Come over here, click on refresh. Okay, this is looking amazing. We'll have to do some more settings, but let us see, let us do everything step by step. Okay, so we have this thing over here. Now, as I said you earlier in the demo website, we have this booking page. Let's see. Now, this page is already created. Whenever you want to go to this page, what you do is you go to your website and you just put in your website link /?. Okay, ? And type in booking. Now, as you can see, you are redirected to this thing. Now, because we have colored this reservation bar over here, it is showing right. Now, we have to color this section. First, let's color this date picker. As you can see, we have this in the date picker, we have this thing brown color showing. Let's put in our own favorite color over here. So again, come over here and select this date picker from here. Here it is, date picker, and process. Date picker, highlight date background. Select this, put in your own color over here. And first click on save changes. Let's refresh it. Fine, it is done. Now this section at the top, which you see, this is called process section. Now for that also, we can add all this thing over here, because here it says date picker slash process. So we can do those things over here. First thing is date picker background color. Okay, we don't have to do that. No date picker, date text. Okay, leave these things. Okay, come over here, booking from here. Okay, booking process background. Let's first change the background color. As you can see over here, this is the background color. So booking process background, put in your own favorite color. Booking process text active. Okay, now as you can see, there is one active and there is, these are unactive or inactive. Okay, the first one is active, which is white color, and these one are kind of gray color. Okay, so let us do that. Text active, which is white, which is fine. Booking process color, let us put some gray color like F5. And border color, booking process border, select white. Click on save changes. Come over here, let's refresh it. Okay, so this looks perfect. Now let us see an example how it works. Let's select something and click on check availability. Now, as you can see, when I do so, there are some changes again that we have to do. First is that we have to change this color. Okay, this section. So again, come over here, and I think it is okay. Let us see. It is under room, I guess. Select this room. I think it is this one, medium room info color. Let's see. Let's change this thing. I think it is this color. Let's see, medium room info color. Let's put in our own color over here, 1ABC9C. Let's see, I'm not really sure. Okay, let me put it again, 1ABC9C. Let's save changes. Let's come over here, let's refresh it again. Click on check availability. Okay, so okay, this has changed this color. Okay, this has changed this color, room info color. Okay, I'm sorry, I thought it was for this one. No, this is for this one. This is the room info and this is the room info border color. Okay, so let us change the border color as well. Let me make it black and click on save changes. Come over here, let's refresh it. Click on check availability. Now as you can see, that has become black. Okay, now let's see how to change this one. Come back over here and select this reservation bar. And here we have this reservation bar room section background. I think this is the one. Paste in your color over here. Let's see. Select it. Click on save changes. Come back over here. Let's refresh it. Click on check availability. Yeah, that was the one. So now this is working. Now let's click on this. Select this room. Okay, now as you can see here, the text is showing this weird color. Now let's change this text color. Okay, I think, here it is. Text title, make it white. Okay, section text, make it white. And we have some blue color over here for this link. Okay, so make this thing white as well. Okay, now again, click on save changes. Let's refresh it again, check availability, select this room. Okay, now everything is looking better, fine. Now click on go to next step. Now again, here we have to do some changes. This is the edit button. Now let's see how to change this edit button. This is really simple. Now if you see over here, go to room 2 color, okay. When you go to room 2 color, we have this booking summary, edit button background, edit button border, okay. So let's select edit button background. Let us put some color like this. Let us select a darker shade and border, select the same thing and select a much darker shade. Select it, click on save changes. And again, we have to do one more setting over here, because if you see in the demo website, when we select this room and when we go to next step, we see that there are few payment options available over here. Okay, so let us do these things as well. So come back to your dashboard. Now from the left hand side, select hotel option. Okay, now here we have some things to do. Okay, some settings. First thing, we don't have to do anything over here. Okay, if you want to enable this adult children option, you can make this thing on. If you want to disable it, if you don't want different rates for adult and children, you can just make it off. Then we have the next option. When should the room be reserved? When the customer pays for the room or only after booking the room. For example, if you see in this process, when the customer clicks on this button, book now by email and will contact you back. So at that time, the room should be booked only after the payment is complete. So you can select that thing. Now booking price display, select start from, and VAT amount. If you want to charge some VAT amount, you can put in the VAT amount. And here also put in the same block date which you want to block, if you want to block the room. Okay, now deposit amount, you can allow customer to pay part of price for booking the room, okay, or as percentage. For example, if you put 20, then it will be 20%. If you want to disable this down payment kind of system, you can just put in 0 over here. Okay, now payment method, you have, instead of only contact form, you have to select include instant payment and select all the payment which you want to include. So we want to include PayPal and Stripe. So select these two, click on save changes. Okay, now because we have selected PayPal and Stripe, we'll have to do those settings. Okay, first click on this booking page settings and let's see. Okay, rest of everything is fine. Just click on PayPal info and don't do anything. Just put in your PayPal email address at the top. Okay, so I'm putting my PayPal email address at the top. And put in the currency, okay, whatever currency you want to accept, PayPal currency over here. Now click on save changes. Now go to Stripe and let us see how to do this Stripe setting. Go to your Stripe dashboard. Let me show you. Okay, so this is my Stripe dashboard. When you come to your Stripe dashboard, at the left hand side, you have few options. And one option is developers. When you click on developers, you have some more options inside that. So click on API keys. And you have two API keys over here, publishable key and secret key. So let me put my password so that it will reveal it. Okay, so you have two thing over here, publishable key and secret key. Just copy the publishable key from here and paste it under publishable key. copy the secret key from here and paste it under secret key. Click on save changes. Okay, now let's do the final step. Let's again refresh this. Okay, let's book this thing. Just click on check availability, select this room, go to next step. Now as you can see, we are getting all these options. So let us put in this information like first name, last name, email address, phone number, some random phone number, address. Okay, now let us select Stripe and click on pay now. Now I am putting a demo card I am putting my name on the card. Okay, and I am putting a demo card number. Okay, so 4242 4242. Okay, and you can put in any CVV number. Now this is a demo card number just to see whether the payment is working or not. Okay, now let's click on submit payment. Okay, it is loading. Okay, so reservation is complete, as you can see over here. So this is really awesome. Now before we proceed further, if you see over here there are some different phone number and email address given. Now let's see how to change that. If you come over here and go to booking mail, you'll see this thing over here. Now change your email address from here and your phone number from here. Okay, here is your phone number, here is your email address. Just change them from here. Click on save changes. Okay, and put in your email address over here. Okay, put in your email address and your company name over here and click on save changes, so that whenever someone books a hotel with your website, they can get an email from your website. Okay, now let's see whether this thing is showing over here or not. So whenever you want to see any booking whenever there's a new booking on your website, and if you want to see that, then hover hotel options and click on transaction. Now as you can see, this booking is showing Nayar Sheikh, and this is the timing, April 18. If you see the details, you can see the contact details which I have just put. Okay, you can see the room details. So this is the room. Okay, just for one day, one night, two adults. Okay, payment system, you can see the payment, $32 and so on. Okay, so this is perfectly working. Now only few things are left, in fact only three things are left over here. The first thing is that we have to create a menu, and we have to create about us and contact us page. So first let's create those pages. So hover pages and click on add new. First let's create the contact us page. So just type in contact us and click on publish. In fact, we don't even have to do this. What you can do is, from the left hand side, you'll see these tools, hover tools, and click on import. Now at the bottom we have this WordPress. Click on install now, WordPress installer. Now click on run importer, choose file, and go to your media folder, and you'll see one file. Okay, this is how it will look, myblog.wordpress.com, something like this. Select this file, click on open, click on upload and import, and now select your name over here, your thing, and click on submit. Okay, so it says everything is done. Now go to pages. Now if you go to pages, you'll see that two pages already created for you, because you have just imported that file. Now let's see how the contact us page looks. So let's view this page in a new tab. Okay, now as you can see, this is how it looks. We have this thing at the top. We can change this image obviously. Then we have all these things, this map and everything. Now let's do some changes over here. First is, this thing is showing perfectly our map which we have just created. Now let's click on this edit button. So, and let's see how to do some changes over here. So the first thing that we have to do, if you see in the demo website, in the contact us page, at the right hand side there is this information, basic information about your company, your contact information, and your social media link. Okay, so first let's add this thing. So if you see on your website, that thing is missing. So first go to edit page and make sure at the right hand side you have this right sidebar and contact is selected. Okay, so we have this contact selected. Once you're confirmed that this thing is selected, hover appearances and click on widgets. Now from here select this text and make sure contact is selected. Click on add widget. Now if you see in the demo website, first we have some simple text and this heading. So just copy this simple text from here, come to this page and go under text and paste everything, and let's give it a title or whatever we have over here, like before contacting us. Let's give it the same title. Okay, click on save. Now again do the same thing, select this text, make sure contact is selected, click on add widget. Now go to that folder which you have downloaded, and in that you will see this contact sidebar. Open this, and here you have sidebar 2, as you can see. So under sidebar 2 you have these 4 short codes. Copy it from here, come back to your website and paste it over here. Okay, let's give it a title of contact information, and here obviously again you can change your contact information if you want to change your phone number, your email address. Everything can be easily done from here. Okay, so click on save. Now do the same thing, select text, make sure contact is selected, click on add widget. Let's add the title of social media. Okay, come over here, paste it over here. Again go to that file. Now here at the bottom we have this single line. Copy this single line, the complete line, copy it, come over here under text, paste it. Okay, click on save. And again here if you want to change the link, here under href you will see this link http://goodslayer. Delete that and paste in your own link over there. Okay, so it is easily done. Let's come back over here, let's refresh this page. Okay, now as you can see everything is showing properly. Okay, now if you want to change this text or if you want to do anything over here, really easy to do so. Let me show you. Okay, let's edit this page in a new tab. Come at the bottom, we have this box icon, click on this gear icon. If you want to change the icon, you can change it. If you want to change the text, here it is lorem ipsum. Just put in your own text, it will start showing up over here. Okay, really easy to do. So let's cut this thing. So your contact us page is ready. Now like again come back over here, let's see the about us page. Let's view this page in a new tab. Let's see how it looks. Okay, so this is how it looks. Okay, if you see your demo website, let's see the about us page. First thing, if you notice in the about us and the contact us page in the demo website, the image is quite different. So let's see how to put that image first. So if you want to put this image, go to general, hotel style, not here I guess. Okay, go to hotel option. Okay, go to under over elements, you will see this page title background. Select this one, and default page title background, default post title background. So under default page title background, let's add this image. Okay, I think that is the slider image, I guess. So let's add this image, click on insert image, click on save changes, come over here, let's refresh it. Okay, so this is working fine. Now if you see over here, we have some simple text. We have seen how to do changes in this text, and here we have this background image. Let's add this background image over there. Oh okay, if you think this is looking better, you can just leave that thing. Okay, then here we have this image. Let me show you how you can put that image over there. So first let's click on this edit button. Okay, let's scroll down. Here we have this image thing which is missing. So click on this gear icon. Okay, let's upload this image. This image is also given, don't worry. Let me search, here it is. Select this image, click on open, upload, save changes, and let's see whether anything else is missing. Okay, rest everything is fine. If you see at the bottom, this thing is really looking bad. And here in the about us section, everything is white. Now we have seen that we have created a testimonial skin wherein everything is white. So what we can do is we can go over here at the bottom section, select it, and in this skin we can select testimonial, click on save changes, let's click on update, come back to this website, and now as you can see everything is looking amazing. Now let's see how to create this menu and how to add this booking option over there. Okay, so first go to your home page. Now come back to your dashboard and hover appearances and click on menus. Okay, you can name it anything you want. For example, here menu 1 is given. So if you want this thing, just click on create menu. Okay, now make sure this thing is selected. Okay, main navigation menu. Now first we have home, which is fine. Okay, then we have rooms. Now if you want to add rooms, first let's get rid of all these things. We don't want this sample page, we don't want this home, secondary home. Okay, so first let's see how to add this room settings. Let's see what we have under rooms. When you click on rooms, we have different rooms showing. Whatever room we have, it is all showing over here. So if you see, this is the link, your website link slash room. So what you can do, copy your website link from here, come over here, click on custom links, paste your website link /ROOM, just put in room. In the link text, type in rooms. Okay, click on add to menu. Let's drag this thing at the top. Now we have to add this booking option. Let's click on booking. Okay, this form should appear. Now what you can do, again paste in your website link /?booking. Okay, and in the link text you can type in bookings or whatever you want. Click on add to menu. Let's get this thing over here. Then we have contact about us page, which is fine. Just click on save menu over here, come back to this website. Let's refresh it. Okay, now as you can see, this is showing. Let's click on rooms. Okay, you have this room over here. Click on bookings, we have this booking thing over here. Okay guys, with this we have completed this tutorial. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you guys have any doubt, any queries, any questions, any suggestions for me, please leave them in the comment section below. If you think this video was helpful, if you want to learn more amazing stuff, click on that red subscribe button and also click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. If you think this was helpful, then please give a thumbs up to this video. Thanks a lot for watching guys. See you soon.